We've all gathered here today to sit down and listen to this podcast called Stat. I have a very important message to spread, and I think most of you will agree. So I want you to sit back and have a listen and sway to the music and maybe even join in. Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body, but if I touched your body, I might give you the flu. But I gotta think twice, it's just too high a price to pay not to stay inside all day. It's what we gotta do. Oh, but we need some time off to fight this COVID. Time to do our duty for mine and yours. I need to wash my hands and social distance. It's more than just us, baby. We need to stay behind the doors. We need to have faith. We need to have faith. Yeah, we need to have faith, the faith, the faith. We need to cover up our face. Baby, it's just too high a price to pay. So please, please, please do what the experts say. Just follow the rules. Baby, if we work all together now, we can slow this right down and save some lives too. Before this river becomes an ocean, we can stop this thing from spreading even more. Our hospital workers are exhausted. Let's honor all their hard work and stay behind the doors. 'Cause we gotta have faith. We gotta have faith. We gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. We need to cover up our face. Yeah, that's right, everybody. Let's wash our hands. Stay behind closed doors. Do minimal shopping. Honor our hardworking nurses and doctors and hospital staff and EMS and 911 and everybody else. Postal workers, grocery store workers, anybody out there that needs to work to keep our economy going. Let's honor them all. Let's do our duty. Let's keep us all safe. That's it. That's all I have to say. We need to have faith. We need to have faith. Yeah, we need to have faith, the faith, the faith. We need to cover up our face. Hello, everybody out there in podcast land. Welcome to Stats, Shocking Traumas and Treatments. And we are your hosts, Kren.
And Erica.
Coming to you live from Skype. Somewhere in Canada.
Somewhere. We don't know where this is actually bouncing off from, but we're both in our homes.
Yeah, I use a VPN so that I can't be traced.
I can be traced. So if anybody wants to trace me, whatever.
You know what? Just leave her alone. Erica's a good shit.
Yeah, leave me alone.
Yeah. Well. So how you doing, Erica?
I'm doing pretty good, Karen. How are you?
I'm hanging in there. I'm having good days and bad days. Like, I had a complete freak out the other day. I'm going along fine. Doop-a-doop-a-doo. This is okay. Get to spend lots of time with Mary and, I don't know, pick my bum, pick my nose. You know, I feel kind of like an ass for, complaining a little bit. But it's because, I mean, I would like to be in the hospital working, but I can't. I feel like I'm letting my peers down, but I just can't. I put in an application to do telehealth nursing,
right,
and research to try to track down track the cases and stuff, so I'm waiting to hear back if I got hired for that. It's purely volunteer. It's like a non-paid thing, which I don't give a fuck. Like, let's spread our money around and keep everybody under a roof. Yeah. And with food on their table. But anyway, so, you know, I gotta say, like, I have, you know, PTSD and some sort of claustrophobia issues. And
is it your PTSD from me that I gave you?
We were supposed to not talk about that here. I didn't want to shame you.
Oh,
Well, it's actually doing better because I barely see you. Actually, the PTSD is because I don't get to see you.
I know, I'm so sad.
Yeah. But anyway,
Karen,
no, I'm
have
hanging in.
each other.
We're doing well. I mean, Mary, she's got a business that's closed, but it's got to be closed. So, overall, it's been interesting and definitely doing my best to stay sane and creative. I've fallen behind on doing this podcast a bit because sometimes I find it hard to talk about stuff when this is in our face.
Well,
Like
yeah.
what's currently happening right now seems so much more important to me than telling a story that's happened before, but then I realize that's bullshit. Like, I mean, we still have to talk about the world life because
Because the world is still moving, it's still going around. It's, like we I've been
Yeah, let's hear about you. Sorry, I went on about myself right now because I want everybody to tell, I want everybody to hear how you're doing and what's going on with you.
I'm doing okay. I'm going to work every day. I work for the post office in Canada, so Canada Post. It's been okay. We're trying to keep safe. There's been quite a few cases though, in and amongst Canada Post, which is a little bit scary.
My God.
None at our depot yet, so that's good news. I mean, a lot of us say that if it does come into our depot and somebody is a confirmed case, we're just all gonna band together and be like, no, we can't do this.
No.
It's not worth it.
You are definitely on my list of, and you guys are on my list of people who I admire greatly and very much am grateful for. Because you guys are part of what's keeping the Canada going and keeping things moving, and you're in harm's way. So I want to thank you, Erica, for just going in and doing it. I mean, yeah, I we.
It's one thing, if this is going to go anywhere, I don't know if it will, but one thing I do want to say is, order essentials. Essentials are the most important thing right now for everybody. And the biggest problem we're having at work now is people ordering the stupidest things. Like, I get you want to order sex toys. I really do. I understand it's a pandemic. We're staying home. We want to, have some fun with ourselves and others. I totally get it. But like, don't order in mass quantities, man.
Quantities. Won't your
Yeah, like
electric toothbrush do the same thing?
you'd think,
Get a
but
little bit of
no.
A535 and an electric
Yeah.
toothbrush and a couple pots and pans and
And you're good.
yeah,
And people
a
don't clearly have
television clicker.
people don't clearly have our imagination, but I think it's just there's a lot of things coming through the mail that aren't essential, and that is the thing. And we have to touch everything that comes through there, and we're putting our lives at risk to get your essential items to you. So
Anal
please,
beads.
your anal beads aren't an essential item,
Yeah.
and I don't want to touch them. So, I mean, gloves can only do so much. We know what's in your packages. We
Yeah.
feel it.
We feel it.
We feel it. So, I mean, just try and stick to the essentials is what I'm saying. It's just there's so much. We're really swamped right now. All the services, Amazon and all of those places are trying to do their best, and UPS, and we can't handle the mass quantities right now. So there's no delivery dates. There's no confirmed deliveries right now because we can't get through them.
Probably, are you just keeping your head above water, kind of?
Yeah, it's everything has to be cleaned before it comes into our depot. So all of that mail has to be sprayed before we touch it. And it's for us, it's not only the threat of COVID. It's some people have reactions to the sprays that, the packages are sprayed with, and
Absolutely.
it's a lot. So, I mean, we'd
Well,
like to stay home too, but we can't.
yeah, no, that's a great message you're sending, Erica. I think it helps to hear directly from the source what you're dealing with, and maybe we can slow down what we need to get. Mary and I have it's run through our head, like, how do we do this shopping thing? Do we order groceries online so that we can
Right.
be less in the store? Like, we only go one at a time. We never go in together, obviously. But Or do we go to the grocery stores as long as we can to cut back so that the people that are delivering can get to, you know, the elderly or the disabled or, you know, a single mother's stuck at home, that kind of thing. They don't want to drag their kids out. So what we've sort of come to the conclusion is that we're just going to go out as we need it,
yeah,
rarely, and we go together, and one of us waits in the car just to help the other person bring the stuff in. Do you know what I'm saying?
And then, that's how it should be.
It's, or we walk up to we got a store up the road, and we walk up together. One stays outside, the other one brings it to the cart and our little cat carrier that we have.
That's the cutest. Is that the one in your trunk?
It's a little baggy. It's like a old lady carrier with cats all over it. So we,
you know what?
Like,
it's a Karen and Mary carrier. That's what I would say. Yeah. It's not even a lady carrier.
It's like, it's such a lesbian and thing. And it's funny. Anyway,
it is.
That's why we got it. I was just like, that's the cutest and gayest thing I've ever seen. We're getting it now. I don't care what it costs.
It is very cute and gay. It is very cute and gay. I think everybody should get one. Not only the gays.
Not only the gays. So yeah. So, you know, Erica, thank you. And I guess, you know, not, I guess, I don't know why I said that, but thank you to everybody out there who is working their friggin' asses off right now.
Yeah.
I can't say it enough.
Especially Costco workers. Holy shit. Like, Costco is insane. I was in Costco yesterday. I got toilet paper and some essential items that we needed for groceries. And holy shit, Costco, good for you guys. You know, they're so busy right now. It was a probably about a half an hour lineup to get in, and it was so smooth. Everybody was wearing masks. And this is a thing I'm going to say, this is my own personal opinion. You go out, cover your damn face, you know, hands. I get, you don't have to wear gloves, you know, wash your hands, use hand sanitizer and all that, but cover your damn face, not only to protect yourself, but to protect people from you. The frontline workers who are going to work, they need to shop too. They need to do all these things as well. And, you know, if everybody covered their face to protect themselves and protect other people, I mean, maybe we could actually flatten this curve and, you know,
yep,
get things going a little faster. You know, keep your kids at home and out of harm's way too. Don't bring your kids along for a shopping trip. Try. I get it. Single parents, I totally understand. But, you know, somebody you trust, somebody, you know, maybe get them to watch the kids, like your dog. Get your dog to watch the kids, you know?
Or leave your kids at home and bring your dog.
Hey, that's perfect.
Well, you know, I don't promote that, but I kind of promote it. No, all joking aside, the one thing that I wanted to okay, well, you just said gloves, wear masks and wear gloves. Now, here's the thing. The whole point of, okay, why would we wear gloves? We would wear gloves so that we don't get this shit on our hands. Yes, but if we touch our face, if we touch other things, the gloves are useless because
gloves give a false sense of safety.
That's exactly what I was going to say, Erica. False sense of safety. So those gloves are as good as the first thing that you touch.
That's it.
That is all. So you need to, like, forget the gloves unless, okay, if you have, here's the thing. If you have open sores, like if you have a cut on your hand or something like that, or your skin is really raw and it's more susceptible to picking up some kind of infection, I think it's a great idea to cover your hands.
Yes.
Just pretend the gloves on your hands are your friggin' face. So you need to, I'd say don't wear gloves and spray the shit out of your hands and wash them properly, because you said false sense of security. Oh, I've got gloves on, I'll be fine. Let's rub my eyes and pick my nose and everything. Now, I'm not saying most people would do that, but they forget. Like, I saw some woman walking around with gloves, and they were way too big, and they were, like, turning backwards down her hand, and she was using her pant leg, to push them up her arm. And I'm thinking, okay, so you just touched everything on your clothes.
Nothing. And now you're sitting in your house.
The other thing Mary and I are doing is we have our outdoor clothes, our outdoor walking clothes. We're trying to go for a walk every day or go to the grocery store. We take off what we've just been out with and hang it on a door. And then after, like, depending on the trip we have, it either goes in the laundry right away or it just stays there, and that's what we wear. Also, our outdoor walking shoes, which, you know, we don't wear our shoes around our house anyway, but you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know if that'll help, but it can hurt. So, you know, just some ideas of, but we were wearing gloves at first. We're like, what the fuck are we wearing gloves for? Because honestly, it doesn't make any sense.
Well, you think that it's like you put them on and you're like I wear gloves all day at work, but
That's different, though.
that's very different because I'm touching things that have, we're getting these packages from all over the world. We had a bunch of packages come in from New York, and I'm like, New York is like insane right now. And like we have to touch these things. And that's the thing, they're saying, they say to us,
Oh,
it's
people
such
that are
a low
working
risk.
that are in like direct contact with
Wear gloves.
you have to be covered. Now, hey, okay, so wear gloves if you want to wear friggin' gloves, people. But think about it, that pretend your gloves are just your hands anyway, because you touch your face, you can contaminate yourself just as much. Unless I said like you have open sores or something like that.
And one thing that drives me mental is what I see all the time. And I'm going to just, this is a tidbit of information from a medical professional. Karen, you'll agree with me right away. You see people with gloves on and they're hand sanitizing the shit out of those gloves. Every time you sanitize those gloves, you're breaking down the gloves. So you're
Exactly.
breaking down that barrier. So, it there's no point. There's no
No.
point. You're not doing yourself any good. So please, like, just you gotta wash your hands. Wash your damn hands like they're going out of style. When you're at home, use cream and stuff to make your hands all soft and nice again, but
Yeah.
fucking wash your damn hands and don't touch your damn face.
Exactly. That's I mean,
Or other people's faces.
don't pick your partner's nose
Wow, really?
or the person in line behind you. Say,
Oh.
oh, you got a little bear in the cave here. Let me,
You gotta bear left cave, left cave. No,
Now it's
yeah,
stuck in your
move
teeth.
it over to your right lip. Hanging off your top lip.
Ooh.
And then wiggle
Okay.
like this.
You don't see Erica right now. She's grossing me out.
Sorry.
You know my weakness
Not sorry.
is boogers, and though I brought it up, I started the conversation. All right, so I put a little post up today to say Erka and Kren are recording in a couple of hours. Any questions? So we do have some questions. Let's go through them. First of all, we have Lorraine. Should I eat the whole batch of cookies that I just made? You want to take this one,
Yes.
Erica? Take it.
Yes, Lorraine. God damn it. Yes. With some gin, I think, because I know that that's your favorite.
Dip the
So.
cookies in the gin.
Oh, hey.
Or
That
better
sounds.
yet, make cookies with gin. Dip them
Think
in
would work.
gin. Wow. Yeah, Lorraine,
You know
eat them
what?
all and take a picture of it.
Take a picture of it. And you know what, Lorraine? Grab like cookie cutters. Fill the cookie cutter, like put it on the counter, fill it with gin, and then drink the cookie gin with a straw. Fuck the cookies.
Just say, well, I had the molds out. You can just keep all the
Yeah.
containers on. Okay, so just basically at the end of it, we're saying drink gin
Drink gin, Lorraine. Drink
and
gin.
eat all the cookies if you want. All right,
Damn it.
next. Next question from Lorraine. What has an in okay, what has being in isolation taught you? Sorry. Me and reading, God's sakes. What has being in isolation lockdown taught you? And is there anything from it that will keep you And is there anything from it that you will keep after this shit show
Of
of
a school.
isolation is over? Okay, do you wanna start with that and I'll answer mine, you answer yours first.
Yeah, I'm gonna say it's taught me I'm never gonna cancel plans ever again. That is a one thing for sure. It's taught me, you know what? Okay, I'm gonna get deep for a second. It's taught me to listen to myself more.
Okay.
It's taught me that having time to myself isn't the worst thing. I kind of learned that I enjoy my company a little bit. As crazy as that sounds,
That's not crazy.
I do. I really do. It's I enjoy the peace a little bit sometimes, and I think that I'm going to take out of it that I'm going to spend more time with myself and listening to myself and listening to my body and stuff, you know?
Yeah, I mean that's amazing. Because sometimes, there's so many distractions out there, right?
Yeah.
And so many
Oh, it
that
also taught me that I can't do push-ups.
Oh.
So there's that.
So why were you doing push-ups or trying to?
Well, I'm exercising. I'm trying to, we have like a little weight lifting thing in the basement with a bench and all this, and we have a punching bag and stuff like that. And so I did learn that you need gloves to punch the bag or you'll split your knuckles. And I learned that you should have a spotter while lifting, trying to think that you're stronger than you are.
Oh my God, Erica, where you are the most dangerous person ever in a gym, aren't you?
I absolutely am.
I can lift 450, no problem.
Yeah, I was like, I can lift 150, no problem.
I didn't know wrist bent that way.
150, no problem. No, I can't. I can't lift 150, no problem.
That's lifting yourself up over your head.
Right. So, oh, yeah, it's lifting fucking half of myself over my head. So it's heavy. It's I got one side up, and then I had to struggle with the other side. So
keep
I like
from falling on your neck,
got
right?
One foot shimmied down, and then had to push the other side up with both hands. Like, and I was spent after one lift. Like,
I've fallen and I can't get up.
Yeah, it was one of those. So Erica. I've definitely learned safety never takes a holiday.
Oh, Erica, get your shit together.
I got to. Yeah. What did you learn, Karen?
What have I learned about being in isolation? What has it taught me? Well, honestly, to share my space.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I spend a lot of time alone. Which I love. See, I've always loved, I like being alone.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I like my quiet time. I'm totally comfortable with myself. I'm that one person sitting down, at a restaurant eating and they're like, oh, that poor thing. She has no friends. I'm like, no, fuck that. Yeah, I like going out for lunch with people, but I do like my time alone. That being said, it's not much sharing with Mary because she's just so easy. Like she's just so easy. But you know what? I've learned maybe communication. I thought I was a decent communicator, but I realized that I leave a lot inside my head.
Yes.
Because I don't want to like share some shit that might be, I don't know, dark, or I'm just it's busy head. With Mary, I've had to learn to maybe communicate a bit better with her instead of just like not saying much. Because she's here too. So, we've learned how to, we've always been comfortable in each other's company. Like we can sit for, we don't have to talk ever. You know what I mean? But I guess for me, I just need to communicate more better about, you know, how I'm feeling. Does
of
that, I mean, it doesn't sound, it sounds like I'm making it all about me, but I'm just saying like, and also.
Well, it should be all about you right now. And your safety and Mary's safety, of course.
Yeah, but you know, it's sort of just like, hey, you know what? I just gotta go. I guess it's that thing because she's always worked a ton. I've always been a very independent person, and we've spent the last month and a bit together nonstop, and it's been amazing. Like I love the time with Mary, but I don't think we spent any more than 4 days alone by ourselves ever.
And I know Mary can be a monster, so I mean that's tough for you.
She's getting really out of hand.
Is she? I can't even imagine.
Yeah. The other day, I'm getting a bit worried about her. So I know we've done an episode before where we talked about how my hallways in my apartment smell like weed.
Yes, we did.
And so it was coming through the door a bit and Mary goes, looks like someone just had a wake and bake.
And she's a monster. She's
and it sounds so funny. And I'm like, what's going on? And then we were watching a TV show and she's like, what, he went to prison for a dime of crack? And I'm like, whoa, wait a minute.
A dime of crack, Mary? Come on.
What is going on with you?
Can you do me a favor, Karen?
Yeah.
Right now?
What?
Can you get Mary in there for a sec? Just I just need for her to say something into the mic for a sec here.
Okay, hold a sec. Mary? Erica, you keep talking to these people.
Okay, because I think... So what you guys need to know about Mary is that she is the sweetest, nicest woman you'll ever meet in your life. She is so kind, so soft-spoken, but when she wants to say something, she says it. She is, and it sounds serious. So the reason why I wanted to get her in there is I want her to say this thing that she says because I think it's fucking hilarious.
Okay, I have no idea anything that you just said, but Mary is here.
Okay, so can you do me a favor, Karen? Can you ask Mary if she could say, shut your slit lips?
Okay, Mary, Erica
in
wants
her
you to say...
angriest voice.
What, in her what?
Angriest.
Okay.
In her angriest Mary voice.
Erica wants you to say, to shut your slit lips in your angriest Mary voice. Right into the mic. Okay, get down here.
Shut your slit lips.
Whoa. Holy shit. That, see, that coming from Mary, that is scary.
She said that coming from Mary is scary. You hear the maniacal laugh in the back?
Yeah, you can't take that lightly.
Oh, did you hear that?
I heard it.
Mary, go have a drink. Go calm the fuck down.
Go have a Erica? Diamond crack.
Oh, Erica,
what is it?
Shut your whore mouth.
Mary. See? I mean, Karen, I don't know how you're doing it.
I don't know either. Mary, I need some time alone right now.
Yeah.
Go wake and bake or something.
Go wake and, or have a dime bag of crack. Hopefully you won't go to jail.
And then, here's the other thing. This was the one that put me over the edge and I had to, like, go and make myself safe. She said, that person's got a face like a punch. Now,
what?
The hardest that someone, that Mary has ever touched somebody would probably be when she's, like, giving a massage. Like, she's the person that puts the spider on the piece of paper and lets them, and she goes, go now, little one. You'll be safe now.
Here you go. I built you a little web.
My own. I sewed you a little. What are you doing? I'm making webs for the spiders that come in. And I'm making
webs for the homeless spiders. That have lost all their webbing.
That have lost their way. Okay, so from Jennifer Johnson, she said, oh, thank God I'm having stat withdrawals. It's been far too long. I know, Jennifer. I'm sorry. It's not that I'm lacking or we're lacking in motivation. First of all, Erica is working a shit ton. And gotta, you know, organizing how we do things takes time, right? Like shopping and just staying in contact with people.
Yeah.
And dealing with your own, or dealing with our own sort of emotional stuff and
anxieties. A lot of,
yes.
You know, here's the thing. It's a lot of people right now, you know, they say, you know, oh, you have anxiety. You must, like, this must make you crazy. You know what? It actually doesn't. Because anxiety, this is your life every day. You're in a state of worrying about something. And for this is kind of like, all the people with anxiety right now should be like, yes, this is what we fucking trained for.
Yeah.
We've been training for our whole fucking lives.
To freak out for this. Oh my God. Yeah. I see what you're saying, but.
So, you know what? Anxieties unite.
Anxiety unite. For sure. Now. Yeah, and I've as much as I've had some bad days, I've been remarkably calm. But you know what? I think it's because, like, I get this stuff. Kind of. Does it help that I sort of, like, I kind of get it. I'm going to follow it. And that's the deal. And we'll get through it. And we're all in it together. And, you know, thankfully, we're getting amazing support from our government. So, you know, that kind of thing. But I said at the beginning of the show that we've... First of all, Eric and I, just being able to record, we used to meet once a week and sit down in front of each other. We'd have the mics. We'd have great sound. We'd be able to.
We'd have a great lunch.
A great lunch. And we'd feed off each other, right? So doing this, we're doing it by
That's
Skype.
That's not like feeding food off each other or anything. That's like
No. Definitely
because we
can't not.
Talk on this.
No, that's just for, that's our business.
Okay.
That's our business.
That's our business.
Yeah. So, but it's harder because we're doing it on Skype. And first of all, like me, I'm like, ah, oh, the sound's not that great, but it's fine. And it's just hard organizing that even. I mean, it's so things will pick up. But this last month has been like, we came back from New Orleans. And then days later, it got hit like a ton of bricks. And then we've sort of been into, I don't want to say survival mode, but like figuring this shit out mode. And Erica going to work and just trying to figure it out. It's been a bit of a challenge, but you know, we're getting back into it. And as far as like, I'm doing the Lacey Spears case right now and I'm freaking out. Like I'm losing it. I say that about every case I cover. Like I want to kill them. Like I really, really want to kill her.
Yeah.
You know, I guess one thing I've learned during this lockdown is that I could easily be a vigilante.
Yeah, I think a lot of people could. Like I was an old woman the other day. I know it sounds crazy. I was driving home from work and I had gotten off the highway and I'm driving up, you know, all the side streets to get home. And I saw eight teenagers hanging out together.
Oh.
So I pull up to the side of the road, put my four ways on for safety.
Yeah.
And I opened the window and I said, well, you guys all live together? And they're like, we're siblings. And I said, wow, your parents must have been busy. I said, if you guys don't disperse in 5 seconds, I'm calling the cops.
And were they all like assholes to you?
No, actually, I think they were scared. And they all, you know, walked their separate ways. It was kind of by like a subdivision.
Oh, okay.
Standing. So, you know, but they probably just went and around the corner and all hung out together. But like,
just like smug assholes, right?
Yeah. And, you know, I talked to a buddy yesterday. Her husband stopped by to drop me off this really cute thing. He's a good friend of mine. His wife. Oh, sorry. This is a yawn. His wife, works at, the hospital, the local hospital here. And, she works on the COVID floor. And she was telling me yesterday, from the car, we were about 15 feet away. She was telling me that, you know, they're having to reuse masks, put them in Tupperware, take them off into a Tupperware container and put the lid on and then use that. And they're using that one N95 the whole day.
And then we've got asses walking around the streets like this is no big deal. Honestly, yeah, so, I played pretty competitive baseball and I've got a really nice bat and I've got a great swing. I've got really good form. And I'm like, Mary, don't ever let me leave this house with the bat because there's going to be some broken knees. I'm going to be like the Sopranos. I'm going to be like, hey, you over there, you need to break it up. Yeah, fuck you, old lady. All right, you know what? All right, you better run.
You want to see fucking old lady?
I'll give you a count of three. Knock him in one.
Yeah, just
one. Bam!
And I got a little Louisville slugger that was mine from when I was like
eight.
Oh,
I saw it. It's like the size of a spoon, of a wooden spoon.
It's really cute.
Oh,
so
my
that
God.
Was my dad gave me that bat.
I think you and I should go to like Kren and Urca and just walk the streets like the, what is it in California where they wear the berets and they go out and they protect the streets? There's something angels. Let's be them.
I'm down.
Let's keep the streets empty.
See if I can find some berets. Maybe
we'll just wear the wigs. We'll wear the wigs. Yeah. With baseball caps and our sunglasses.
I don't think baseball caps. Fit over those wigs. We'll try.
No, we'll wear knitted caps then or something. Oh my God, that would be hilarious. Okay, moving forward, I want to get back to talking about masks. Actually, this is the perfect time to do that. Masks. People don't realize the whole deal with how masks work in keeping people safe in the hospital. Okay, yeah. First of all, and Erica, I know you know this. When we have to do mask fitting once or twice a year in the hospital.
Yeah, and those are N95s.
Those are N95. So there's the ones that are kind of round, and there's the ones that look like a duck bill.
Yes.
Okay, because everybody has different size faces. So what you do is they put a hood, like a plastic hood over your head, and they spray something that you can smell and taste into it.
And it tastes like balls.
Yeah. So what they do is they take a look at your face or you say, hey, I usually wear the round large, right? They'll say, okay, well, let's try the round and let's try the duck bill. And then you do that. And if you can smell it or taste it, you're not fit properly.
So
it might not actually be the mask. It might be how you're fitting it. So, so you have to go to this through this process to find what fits you properly so that you are fully covered. So what about when there's one mask? And there's only one size. People don't think about this shit. So those assholes that are out there, there's that guy Baruch or whatever in New York who it was like 250,000 masks and all the, you know, spray this like hand sanitizer and gloves and stuff like that. And he was selling it from his house in New York. And the neighbors were like, what the fuck is going on? The FBI got there and they cleared him out. And he's just sort of like, you know, what? You know, what's the big deal? So even so, like getting the mask to the people in the hospital. Okay, fine. So we start to get masks, but it's one each. And are they even the size that fit you? So these guys are that much even more at risk that, of course, the average Joe is not going to know about that. But
no,
we've got people in there going in every day, not knowing if they're going to be covered or not, if they're going to be safe or not, and just doing it. And their faces are falling apart, you know, so I don't know. That's just something I want people to think about with nurses, that it's in doctors and hospital staff. And like, you know what? Some hospital staff aren't even getting masks. Like the people that are cleaning the rooms and porting people around and stuff like that, they're not even getting masks.
No,
what? They're any less at, they're less at risk? I don't fucking think so.
For our face masks, so my size for N95 is 8210.
Okay.
Which is a size that is pretty, it fits a lot of people. A lot of people are that size, 8210.
Yeah.
But that's the thing, is people don't understand the sizes. I saw a guy at Costco.
If you're a tiny little petite woman,
you're not fitting. It's
going to be too big for you. Or if you're a big burly guy, or even have a beard, like that's another reason, like just to not have a beard.
I saw a dude yesterday in an N95 mask, which I wanted to snap off his face. He had such a huge ass double chin that none of it was in the mask. It was all like, it was basically just sitting right over top of his mouth.
So it wasn't even covering his nose.
No.
My son has always had since he was a teenager, a big ass beard. And I said to him, like, you know, I mean, well, trimmed and stuff, but I'm like, you might want to reconsider that. So he's down to a mustache. He kind of looks
good.
Cool, but it's like, yeah, you know what? I didn't even think about that. But just there's dangers going on in closed doors in the hospitals that people aren't aware of. So
they have no idea.
Masks, gloves, the environment, the cleaning, the extra, the all the hours they're working, the wear and tear on everybody. And I know I'm focusing on the hospital people, but I mean, there are essential services that have become essential services. People working in grocery stores, the post office, things like that, all very important. But honestly, first line workers are just like, if I see the average Joe walking around with a N95, I have to keep from going up to them and saying, what the fuck are you doing? Why do you have that? But then I have to think, okay, do they have an underlying, you know, medical illness? Are they hospital workers themselves that are, you know, afraid of spreading it if they go out, if in case they've come in contact? So I try to keep myself calm that way. Because honestly, you know, there are going to be some that aren't those people.
But no.
What are we going to do? We can't do anything about that.
You know what? I got to tell you something. So
I got to keep my, I got to pick my battles.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's get back to these questions, because Candace, had the best one here. She's like, she posts this little meme thing, and it's a brain, and it says, are you going to sleep? And the lady says, yes, shut up. And the brain says, I wonder if Jeffrey Dahmer used seasoning. That is a damn fine question.
Maybe some salt and pepper.
Yes. Maybe some garlic plus.
It's possible. I don't
know. You know, that's nice to add some meat.
Applesauce?
Oh, see, Laura Grandma says, where's my Wondrous shirt? And Candace is probably with all my packages that I haven't got.
It's true. First of all, I worked on the t-shirt. I got it all ready to go. And the people that I order shirts from, they haven't processed it yet. So maybe post a picture of what it looks like and what it's going to be. but honestly, it hasn't even been processed. Like it's saying waiting. I get in contact and they're saying sorry. But, you know, unfortunately, t-shirts aren't essential service. But I can show you a picture and you can, you know, when this is all said and done, that's what's waiting for you. Laura, this is what the whole thing is that you can look forward to that when this is all said and done, that you will get a t-shirt from us.
Yeah.
Like, if that doesn't brighten your day,
I don't know what does.
Exactly.
Tracy Sandman, she writes, best and worst media you have consumed during this pandemic. It can be a movie, music, TV show, book, etc. Karen, worst one? I'm going to have to say it.
Say
Tiger
it.
Tiger King is the worst.
Tiger King is the worst.
I couldn't get through it.
I couldn't finish it. You know what?
What the fuck is wrong with those people?
Most shows that I will watch, I will like, I think anybody does that. You try to find, there's a reason why someone is that way. You at least try to look for it. Some explanation. Like the reason why I do all these horrible stories about doctors and nurses, etc., is because I want to get in and go, what causes someone to do that? Okay. And most of the time I'm like, no, they're still a piece of shit.
Yeah.
Okay. But I could not find one bloody thing to like about any of these people because they're all scumbags. All scumbags. And all you have to do is go wild animals in captivity. That just starts and ends there. Right?
Okay. Number one, wild animals do not belong in captivity. When I was younger, I used to go to the zoo and I used to be like, oh, you know, to my parents, this is so sad. You know, why are they behind bars? Like, why do zoos have to have bars? I didn't understand.
Yeah.
And then I got older, you know, both my parents were huge animal lovers, especially my dad.
Yeah.
And he used to say, when I got old enough, he explained it. And he said, you know, they go where the animals first came from for zoos is they would go out into the wild and catch these exotic animals because they wanted to be able, like, for regular people to be able to see them. And I used to say, well, I don't want to go to the zoo anymore.
Yeah.
And you know what? My parents supported that because they know that that's a really shitty thing. You know, we have more tigers in captivity than we do in the wild.
And that's the thing, like, your parents, that's amazing that they explained it to you the way they did and they gave you that option. And so you could work it out yourself. I can't go to a zoo. Circuses, I just want to forget about it.
I forget. Fuck circuses.
Think about a circus. They're abuse animals and there's fucking clowns there.
Yeah. Like that's not okay.
Anybody who wants to be a clown is mentally ill.
Karen, we could go all vigilante on the circus circuit.
Let's do it. Let's just go in at night and free everything.
Totally down.
All right. That's what we're going to do. Yeah. We have some talking to do. We need to do some stuff to keep ourselves busy, like at a distance.
Meet me in the bat cave.
Will do. Okay. So best media. I've got two that I like I've got more than two, but for right now, I'm going to say that I've watched a documentary series called Why We Hate. It's amazing because it talks about, it just explains, you've got psychiatrists, psychologists, you've got historians, tons of like professionals that have studied, anthropologists, you name it, that have been studying like human behavior and animal behavior and all that kind of stuff. And it goes through like different chapters, like each episode, one is called tribalism. One is called, talking about how, what's the word I'm looking for? Genocide. One's about like sort of like politics and, you know, different things like that. And it's amazing.
Where can you find this, Karen? Like, where did you watch it?
Well, I'm watching it on, I think it's CBC. It's on like kind of regular TV, but I think you can find it on YouTube if you want to look for it. It's called Why We Hate. And it just, I'm always searching for answers, and the way they explain and talk about things I haven't thought of before, or it just helped me wrap my head around what makes me hate and like, should I be hating, and what drives me to do it. And, you know, so that's a really good one to watch. And another one just for fun, Ozark.
So good.
Oh my, oh my, oh my. You know what else I've been watching for fun?
What?
The Canadian Family Feud.
Oh my God, I love you.
It is so funny. Guys, if you have a chance to watch the Canadian Family Feud, you'll really get a sense of what Canadians are all about.
It's hilarious. I even watched it. You know what I've been watching? It's called Helicopter ER. And it's based...
Oh, cool. I've always wanted to do that.
Based out of the UK. And I fucking love it. And it's... You know, here's the thing about British TV. British TV doesn't, you know, they're not all about the putting on the pretty actors and stuff. And you know what? It's better fucking acting because you actually get people who can act.
Yeah, no, you're hired for, and because we're all, most of the world are average looking people.
Yeah.
Like, you know, there's, you know, and then we can go into the whole philosophical eye of the beholder and all that other stuff. But, yeah, no, it's real people acting, and it's excellent. It's excellent.
I fucking love it. So check out those shows. If you guys...
So a book that I found that was really... I mean, I listen to audiobooks all the time, but the one book that I read recently that I want to like buy and give to everybody is called The Way Things Have Always Been. I think that's what it's called. I'm gonna have to find it. It's this book is just it's amazing, and I will find it so and post it. Okay, so that's sort of our questions answered for now, and I you know hope you guys are staying safe out there. I'm gonna say something, Erica.
Give it, Karen. Say it.
I've been asked not to be. Or to avoid being political on the stat page. And I thought, okay, that's a good idea. Let's keep politics out of things. And it's been suggested that politics and stat have nothing to do with each other. Well, I disagree.
I disagree as well.
Because, first of all, the politics I'm talking about involve healthcare, safety, medicine, medical things. So I'm going to talk about it.
I want you to. Give her.
And I don't want to be that person, but I guess I'm going to be that person. It's my show. It's my, it's my Facebook page.
Yep.
I'm an opinionated person. You know, everybody's got an opinion, whatever, you know, like an asshole, everybody's got one. Fine. And I may be wrong, but if I sit on it, honestly, not my asshole, but yeah, my asshole. if I sit on it, I like my brain boils. And when I see stuff happening that is so selfish, so fucked up, so dangerous, so like sociopathic, like pathological.
That. Is it like that they opened a beach in Florida yesterday and a bunch of fucking people went to the beach?
Yes.
Or
no, I mean, it's everything. Yeah. It's Trump saying free this, free Michigan, free. Like, so basically he's put in orders to stay at home and then he says and fights himself and says free everybody. It's people that are still going to church. It's people that are showing up with machine guns in front of, you know, places to protest being stuck at home. You know what? I'm a proud Canadian. There's no doubt about this, and this isn't me comparing my country to your country, but the, you know, and I see other countries around the world are working their ass off and doing everything they can. And you know what? The US always prides themselves in being number one. Well, way to go, fucking Trump, because you're number one in COVID cases. You're number one in deaths. You're number one in all that kind of stuff. You're number one in, people in prison. You're number one in drug addicts. You're number one in poverty, keeping people under their thumb. You're number one in I can go on and on and on and on and on. Again, I'm gonna probably get shit kicked thinking that I'm taking this out on Americans, and I am not. Your president
not
is
at all.
Your president is fucked. The good people are getting screwed over. The racism and poverty is disgusting. And there's more worry about the big companies getting their buyouts than the average Joe getting enough money to feed themselves with. So,
yep.
And when I see that the people are supporting this maniac, this guy who's encouraging civil war, and I may sound like one of those conspiracy theorists, but I'm telling you, this is basically when you've got these... doomsdayers that have been prepping for the end of the world. They're like, oh yeah, it's our time now. You can't make us stay at home. Well, you know what? You can't convince an idiot, right? And someone who thinks they're right is too dumb to realize that there's another option, and that's being wrong and opening your mind up to being right or wrong and somewhere in between. So I am sick and tired of pussyfooting around this subject matter. I'm not going to make it the center of things, but I'm also not going to keep my goddamn mouth shut about it anymore, because this is ridiculous. Ridiculous. And listen, I see so many people.
I don't agree more.
They're suffering. People are dying. And you can, and you, let's open up. Oh, that's a fan fucking tasket idea. Let's open up. So the idiots that are the COVID idiots that are already out there thinking it's not a big deal. Well, let's just open up again, and then they're just going to go hog wild, and the borderline ones are going to go, yee-hoo! And it's just, oh, what'll happen? I don't know. We'll have a second wave of it.
Yep.
This is a process, everybody. The reason why the U.S. has 740,000 cases, and we have 33, yes, there's a population thing here, but if you look at it per capita, And you look at other countries per capita, you know, that's I could go on and on. You know I can, but I'm so fed up of having to, you know, being told basically to keep it to yourself and don't get political. Well, you know what? This is life and death. And
everybody's entitled to their own opinion. And I think that if you can't say anything, then you're doing a disservice to yourself. So
well, here's the thing. We can talk about it unless it upsets other people to talk about it.
Yes.
And don't pussyfoot around. Like you need to be careful about the ones that may disagree with you. Oh, don't upset Republicans because you're not being fair. Well, they can say whatever they want.
Yep.
And there's responsibility in what you say. So if I say stuff that's shit, then I'm responsible for the shit that comes out of my mouth. But I got to also expect to get shit back. And I fully expect to get shit back. Anyway, the other thing that's pissing me off is these so-called fucking celebrity doctors. We got Dr. Phil with a PhD in psychology saying there's more swimming pool drownings every year. Do we shut down the country because people die in a pool? Yeah, because dying in pools are contagious, right, Dr. Phil?
Yep.
Oh, and then Dr. Oz, what did he say? The 2.2 to 3% death rate is acceptable to open everything up again. Okay, so 2 to 3% times a million, carry the 4. Fuck, too many! Especially in schools.
Yeah.
We can sacrifice.
They don't.
What about Dr. Drew? Oh, this isn't real. It's a conspiracy theory. I hope these guys lose their fucking audience. But they won't. They won't. No. All they have to say is, oh, sorry. So forget it. You know, so there's just so much. And then you've got someone like Lady Gaga, who is like considered the crazy meat dress lady, who organizes something so fucking incredible yesterday to bring the world together.
Yep.
What happens? Trump cuts off money to the WHO. You got a problem with them? Deal with it after. Deal with it after the virus things have settled down. You don't need to do it now. So what does she do? She says, let's throw a benefit so we can get money to the WHO. What does Bill Gates do?
$50 million.
Yeah. And what does Bill Gates do? He gives up. I think he said it was like $300 million that he gave to the WHO right afterwards. And was like, fuck you, Trump. You know? What about the churches? How much is Rome donating?
You mean Rome?
No, like the Catholic Church. They're one of the richest things. Like, what are, like, Tesla. What do you call it? I call Eva Knievel. What's his name? Elon Musk.
Yeah.
He's doing shit. Right? So we're seeing, when this is all said and done, whose true colors have reared their ugly heads in this whole thing.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm done.
That was good, though, Karen.
Now I have a headache.
You have a headache?
I gave myself a headache.
Although I don't want you to have a headache, because those headaches last for days for you.
Well, it was worth it. Erica,
well, as long as it was worth it.
I didn't even give you a chance to say anything. So what do you have to say?
I concur.
When I go on my rampages, usually the people that know me and love me just kind of let me do it.
You got to let her go.
I just got to let me go. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you got to let her go. Like, you know. In New Orleans, when she gets an idea, she's got to go.
What are you talking about?
Like, when you want to do something, she's got to go. Remember? And when we were in New Orleans, Karen says, we said, let's go to the cemetery. And Karen went to the cemetery. And she paid $20, but we were too cheap to pay the $20.
It was worth it.
But you know what? You got to let her go. You got to let her do it. And I still didn't see those pictures, FYI.
I'll have to show you them. They're awesome. Okay, well, this has been, I guess, sort of a catch-up, fun-type episode. We talked about many different things. You know, serious, fun, all that kind of stuff. But let's make the next episode just about COVIDiots.
Done.
Okay, but it's not going to be heavy. It's not going to be, you know, too intense. We're just gonna make fun of some of the people out there that have not done too many harmful things, right? Not like Trump,
you know,
or whatever.
Let's do a thing right now. I want to start seeing pictures on our Facebook page of the best PPE that you've seen out there while you've been either going to the grocery store.
Oh, you mean like knitted, like sewn ones and stuff?
I want to see, yeah, your best homemade PPE that you guys have seen.
Or made.
Or made.
Okay. That's a great, great thing. So post your PPEs.
I want to see it.
Okay.
Post your PPEs.
Post your PPEs. Wink.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Okay. Well, I think it was good to catch up and do this episode today. You know, things are unusual. We're in unusual times, so episodes are going to be unusual. And whatever.
I
think you and I should do a Facebook Live soon.
Done.
Okay. Okay, well, let's just say goodbye to everybody. It was nice recording again, and I'll finish up that episode on Lacey
Spears.
Yeah,
I know. Sorry. And I just hear, Lorraine, this one's for you. She's probably hammered by now from eating all her gin cookies.
Her gin cookies.
So Lorraine, if you want to send us any messages after you've eaten those cookies, feel free to do so.
Yes, that would be fantastic. Okay. Nice talking to you, Erica. You stay safe.
Nice.
Thank you for
you,
all your hard work.
You
okay, bye.
Bye.
Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. But if I touched your body, I might give you the flu. But I gotta think twice. It's just too high a price to pay not to stay inside all day. It's what we gotta do. Oh, but we need some time off to fight this COVID. Time to do our duty for mine and yours. I need to wash my hands and social distance. It's more than just us, baby. We need to stay behind the doors. We need to have faith. We need to have faith. Yeah, we need to have faith, the faith, the faith. We need to cover up our face. Baby, it's just too high a price to pay. So please, please, please do what the experts say. Just follow the rules. Baby, if we work all together now, we can slow this right down and save some lives too. Before this river becomes an ocean, we can stop this thing from spreading even more. Our hospital workers are exhausted. Let's honor all their hard work and stay behind the doors. Cause we gotta have faith. We gotta have faith. We gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. We need to cover up our face.
Yeah, that's right, everybody. Let's wash our hands, stay behind closed doors, do minimal shopping, honor our hardworking nurses and doctors and hospital staff and EMS and 911 and everybody else, postal workers, grocery store workers, anybody out there that needs to work to keep our economy going. Let's honor them all. Let's do our duty. Let's keep us all safe. That's it. That's all I have to say.
We need to have faith. We need to have faith. Yeah, we need to have faith, the faith, the faith.